has touched on there. I suppose what Helen's talking about as well is maybe people who wouldn't qualify for surgery here, who are getting surgery that they don't actually need, even though they feel they need it. Are you seeing that in the treatments and procedures that you know people are may seek from you, that you feel, no, you don't need that. You might want it, but it's not necessary. Are you seeing a change there?
I suppose there's two different factors. We discussed body dysmorphia before, and certainly almost 7 to 10% of our patients are body dysmorphic. So when people come to us, there are certain red flags. Number one, if they've been to multiple doctors before, if they talk down doctors and they say, that guy was useless, he didn't sort me out. And we have sort of ways of checking for that. And believe it or not, if you can't see something perceivable that they can see, when we look at an object, it's split into two different factors. There's the physical entity of entering your eye, and then there's the perception of what the brain does. And that includes things like anorexia and nervosa. Mm-hmm. So you can't turn around to somebody and say, I can't see that, and you can. You're just fighting with them. So as a consequence, there are things like if they're mirror checking all the time, if they get into a car and look in the mirror, if they stop outside a shop.
What if they're younger and they don't physically need it? They haven't got the wrinkles, but they're looking for the Botox.
We certainly turn them down.
Do you?
So body dysmorphia are people that are coming too early, if we turn them down. I turned down somebody today, actually.
What would you say that's typical of in your industry?
Don't see it as much now as we used to. I think it's because they're going to seek out people who'll do it anyway, and know that we'll not.
Yeah, and it's interesting though, isn't it? Because it comes down as well to our perception around aging. And when you see, and we are seeing a growing number of young Irish women, that's not just Irish women, but like it's probably a global trend, who are seeking out treatments and Botox and fillers at a young age. Do you think that's something, do you think it's normal, or do you think it's something we need to sort of reflect on as a society?
I do think it's worth reflecting on that as a society. If you think about the messages that, like, we as, say, who are not in our 20s and 30s, the messages we give to younger women and what we think is okay around aging, and it's wonderful to hear Dr. Treacy talk about turning people down like that, in the sense of we have to tell young people that you look absolutely beautiful the way you are, whatever that may look like, and that you don't need to look like, you know, it's okay to look different, it's okay to look like yourself, it's okay to age as well.
Or is there something to be said for, well, if you want to get it, and I mean, you know, we are living in the modern age that there are these pressures, and if it makes somebody feel better and they are not underage, then they're perfectly entitled to go and get treatment should they wish to do so.
They are perfectly entitled. And I think that's the kind of the point, I suppose, of the show earlier on, the program earlier on, is that is around who and how you make those decisions. So like for most people, they're perfectly entitled and it may make a huge difference to their self-esteem or self-image. But for a small number of people who are really pursuing it beyond the realms of what's actually okay for them, or maybe dangerously, or seeking procedures and without the proper checks and balances around, why do you want this? You know, what do you want? Why do you want it? And who really wants it?
Yeah.
Like, is it a pressure from a relationship or a friend or something else?